Good evening, church family. We are here to praise and magnify the Lord. We are here to thank Him for His goodness, His mercy, and His grace. And He has given us a homecoming theme that's going to take us to heaven. And we just want to praise Him for that. He is giving us the power to be all that we can be in His service, because we are expecting greater. And because we're expecting greater, we can lift our voices and praise Him and give Him the glory and the honor. We just want to thank Him for all that He's done for us. And we want to praise Him for His deliverance. He has delivered us from so many things this year. He has helped us to overcome things in our life that only He can help us to overcome. So we thank Him. We glorify and praise His holy name. Father, Lord, as You have delivered us from the snares of the devil and all of the obstacles that he has thrown our way in 2023, what a mighty God we serve. We thank You, we magnify, glorify, and praise Your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Good evening, family. It's a pleasure to be here with Pastor Emmanuel Charles, of course, the esteemed first elder of the Mount Sinai Seventh-day Adventist Church. Pastor Moffitt, you know me, and we just enjoy being part of the leadership of our wonderful church family. We've gathered here this evening to basically celebrate the 40th year anniversary, our homecoming celebration. We're just excited about what's been going on. The Lord has been blessing us richly. And Pastor Emmanuel, how do you feel about this wonderful journey that we are on?
Listen, the moment I heard that we were going to do this, these four phases, I was really excited to see what the Lord was going to do for Mount Sinai. As you know, Mount Sinai is the only church in town, so I knew the Lord was going to come in and pour into Mount Sinai.
Amen. Praise the Lord. And so when we talked about those four phases, we're referring to deliverance for the first quarter. We went from there to obedience the second quarter. We went to forgiveness the third quarter. And we finished up the last quarter with promise. Deliverance. Pastor Emmanuel, what do you... How do you feel about deliverance?
Well, deliverance during that first phase, we looked at what God had done for His children. Yeah. And the fascinating thing for me about deliverance, when I look at the children of Israel, was how God allowed Pharaoh to seemingly get away with a lot of things. Oh, yeah. And I love the last part of deliverance when he said, "This time, now, I'm coming down." That tells me that God may allow some things to go through, but at some point, if he decides that he's going to come down, nothing can stop him from doing what he wants to do. And the 10th plague, he said, "I am coming down." And so with that, during that first quarter, I said, there are some things that are going to move because God is going to move on behalf of his people.
Powerful, powerful, powerful. When I look at deliverance, I think about the word deliverance. The word deliverance is just like that word Trinity. Even though those two words are powerful in Christendom, you really don't find them in the Word of God. But when you think about the deliverance as a definition. It's basically the act or action of being set free. So we can safely assume that the opposite of deliverance is captivity. Uh-huh. And when you think about captivity, when you think about the children of Israel, Pastor Charles, you know, it's amazing to me that it wasn't the need of workers in the field that brought their enslavement on. It was basically the fear and the paranoia and the jealousy mm-hmm. of a Pharaoh who knew not Joseph.
Exactly.
And I think about that, you know, when we talk about the deliverance of the children of Israel and how magnificent God did this, man, I'm forced to think about what it's going to be for us, because our journey with the devil resembles that. It's his fear, his paranoia, his jealousy.
Yes.
That has us under the grips of sin. But I'm looking forward to that day when God comes in the clouds of glory and we inherit everything that the devil abandoned by way of rebellion.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Time measured out my days. Life carried me along. And my soul I yearned to follow God, but knew I'd never be so strong. I looked hard at this world to learn how heaven could be gained, just to end where I began, where human effort is all in vain. Were it for grace, I can tell you where I'd be, wandering down some pointless road to nowhere, with my salvation up to me. I know how that would go. Battles I would face, forever running, but losing the race, were it not for grace. So here is all my praise, expressed with all my heart, offered to a friend who took my place and ran a course I could not start. And when he saw in full just how much his love would cost, he still went the final mile between me and heaven, so I would not be lost. Were it not for grace, I can tell you where I'd be, wandering down some pointless road to nowhere, with my salvation up to me. I know how that would go. Oh, the battles I would face, closing the race, were it not for grace. Forever running, losing the race, were it not for grace.
Father in heaven, we just thank you so much. In the year of 2023, you have delivered our church family from COVID. You delivered us and opened doors that we would have roof over our heads. You have delivered us from storms and hurricanes that have come our way. You have given us jobs. Lord Jesus, you have taken so much good care of us that we don't know how to do nothing but magnify, glorify, and praise your holy name. In the precious, powerful, wonderful name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.